أن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد Praise be to Allah, إخواني الحمد لله رب العالمين that Allah سبحانه وتعالى made for us days where we can join together and remember Him so that we may share our experiences and transmit our own iman to our fellow brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed me to come to this blessed community for the first time to meet these blessed, pious, and pure faces that I see today. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and bless our offspring and bless everyone around us and to make us a reason for others to be guided. Ameen. Ikhwani, today I will speak about something very important. Something that every one of us thinks of or should be thinking of. When they're by themselves at night, or when they're sitting alone and reflecting on their own lives and what they left behind. Ikhwani, I'll be speaking about our own legacy. The legacy that we leave behind. And this is something that I was thinking of all throughout this past Ramadan. And as you know, Ramadan is the month of Quran, the month where we are alone with the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we get to reflect on His verses, so that it is as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking to us, and answers any question that we may have. This month, I was thinking of, what will I leave behind? And as I was reading the Quran, I was thinking, Ya Allah, what will others remember me as? What will I be seen as? What did I leave behind in good so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can look at me as a servant and say, this person planted a seed in this place. This person planted a tree in that place. This person left a good family behind, a good boy or a good girl that will carry on the legacy they left behind. And this is something I was thinking of. And this is something every one of us thinks of. Would it end? Would me, my name, end when I am buried and dirt falls on my face? Or would others remember me in good and make dua for me? Or would I leave behind the best of that which I can leave behind, which is a child that makes dua for me after my death? And as I was reading the Qur'an, I noticed that Ibrahim alayhi salam was the name that kept repeating itself in my head. And I thought of the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam over and over. First, when he was giving his own father da'wah, and he was referring to him as Ya Abati, O my father, in the most humble sense, subhanAllah, Ya Abati. Ya Abati, Ya Abati. Constant reminders to his father, humbling himself. So I noticed Ibrahim alayhi salam really, really cared about his family and cared about his father and his parents. And then when he lost hope with his father, it didn't stop there, but his care for his family increased until he went alone and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with a child from his wife Hajar, his child Ismail alayhi salam. And reading the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail, and just to shed light on who Ibrahim alayhi salam is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. From all of the prophets and messengers in the Quran, Allah chose Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah To be who? To be a close companion to him. وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And not only that, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim by making him the leader of mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. I made you an imam, a leader for all people. So this isn't just any personality, ikhwan. This is someone who Allah made a leader for all people. In what? This is what I'll shed light on, inshallah, later on this khutbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only blessed Ibrahim as a person by making him a close companion and by making him a leader for mankind, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also blessed his whole family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا آلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. And we gave the family of Ibrahim the scripture and wisdom. وَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا. We gave them a great kingdom. So Allah gave his family a great kingdom. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا. Allah chose Adam and Nuh. وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. And the family of Ibrahim. Subhanallah. Not only himself, but his whole family. So what did Ibrahim alayhi salam do in order to make his family this important to humanity and this important to mankind until the day of judgment? Allah made him a leader, and Allah made his family, his successors, the leaders of mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ja'ala fi dhurriyatihi an-nubuwwata wal-kitab. Allah made in his descendants nubuwa, prophecy or prophethood, and kitab, and Allah revealed the books to his descendants. So what was Ibrahim alayhi salam? All I want to mention today is walk through the verses. I want to walk through the verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first mentioned Ibrahim alayhi salam in his story. And then I'm going to shed light on some aspects of this story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Because each and every one of us wants to leave a legacy. Of course, we will never leave a legacy like Ibrahim alayhi salam, because Allah chose him. But we can learn lessons from the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam so that we can deliver a message the way he delivered, and that we can be remembered in good the way he was remembered alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذِ بِتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim with commands, and he completed them, and he fulfilled them, alayhi salam. قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Allah said, I will make you a leader for mankind. Because he completed these commands. What did Ibrahim alayhi salam say? He didn't say, okay, oh Allah. He said, قَالَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي. He said, what about my descendants? Ibrahim alayhi salam always had his family in mind. And this is something that's repeated. And if you read the Quran from beginning to end, you will always notice that the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam wasn't only for him. It was always for his kids and his descendants after him. He never was selfish and thought of himself. Many of us think of our own goals, and we think of us, and we think of what we want to accomplish, and what we want to establish, and what we want to make and create and invent. But we forget that our kids are going to come after us, and they will carry on this legacy, or they will hate it because of our neglect for them in our efforts to achieve our own goals. Our kids will see the selfishness, and they'll sense it at a young age, and they'll be raised with it. And if they are neglected, they will hate this goal that you set for yourself to achieve. Ya Ikhwan, we have to keep this in mind. No matter how good your goal is and how noble it is, if we don't involve our kids in it, and no matter how blessed and how sincere your dua is, if you don't incorporate and involve your kids in your dua and put them in your dua, there's a big problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues saying, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Ibrahim alayhi salam not only made dua for his kids and not only asked Allah continuously to involve his kids in his greatness, in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be. He always thought of his children to an extent where he found an activity, a blessed and holy activity for him to do with his own child. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدِ. And Yarfa' is a fi'l mudara. Ibrahim alayhi salam was lifting the Kaaba and building the Kaaba along with who? With his own son Ismail, involving him so that his son can do what? Can place the bricks of the house that will give his kids and his descendants a responsibility until the Day of Judgment. And that is to clean the Kaaba and purify it and make it ready for those people who come to do ruku' and tawaf and to prostrate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this place. He built the Kaaba with his son. This is a father-son activity, Ikhwan. This is something that not only the father did and left his son, but he made his son put his fingerprint in it. So that when the father dies, his son sees it as a part of him as well. And not only that, but Ibrahim alayhi salam says, as he was building, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Oh Allah, accept from us, not from me. Even though he was the one given the responsibility to build the Kaaba, but he chose to involve his son and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously to accept from us, so that his son can watch him and say, this is me and my father doing this. It's not my father's job that he just added me to. It's not something I'm helping my father achieve or accomplish. No, it is us together. And that's what we understand from the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَثَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنًا وَالْتَخِذُ مِنْ مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلًّى. وعهدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. And not only that, but Ibrahim عليه السلام chose, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for them both, the safest place on earth, a place that is surrounded with mountains, a place that will be very difficult for the enemies to come and destroy. So he chose this place, he chose a safe place for his son. He planted his children, he planted his family, he planted his descendants in a place where he sees will not be a corrupt place for them. A place that he sees they can accomplish the goal in pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in. وَأَمْنَا وَاتَّخِذُ مِنْ مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلَّى. And not only that, but Ibrahim alayhi salam left a place for him, something that reminds his family of him and his descendants of him. They constantly pray, it's a ibadah. A ibadah, ikhwan, that connects his son, his children to him. So every time they do this ibadah, they remember their father. We should be thinking right now, what ibadah, what worship am I doing that's between me and Allah that I am involving my children in? Something that my children look around and see and say, SubhanAllah, my father always gave this charity organization salawat. My father always prayed Qiyam al-Layl, no matter when he was traveling, when he was at home. My father always smiled when he was out in public. My father did this, my father did that. It's something that they will do after and they will remember their father with. This is what we should be thinking, ya ikhwan. And Ibrahim alayhi salam continues to make dua until he came to death. He said what? He said, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبِ يَا بَنِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. So Ibrahim alayhi salam gathered his family. He gathered Ismail, wa Ishaq, and not only that, but his grandchild Yaqub as well. Because it is not only his children he wants to leave his legacy with, but he wants to leave his legacy even with his grandchildren and make them involved. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. Don't forget, Yaqub was born at the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam, so he had to be involved. So this shows us, this Wayaqub shows us that Ibrahim alayhi salam not only wanted to raise his own kids and say, Ya Allah, I did what I wanted. I did what I had to do. I raised my children to the best of my ability. Inshallah, they can carry on and raise their kids. Inshallah, I did my job. They have to do theirs. La, Ibrahim alayhi salam was concerned constantly to an extent where he even involved his grandchildren. And these are just wisdoms, Ya Ikhwan. We can read and extract and do tadabbur and reflect on the verses all alone, and we can come up with things that some mufassirin didn't come up with. But we have to understand that this Quran has the best way of life in it. All we have to do is look for it, Ya Ikhwan. All you have to do is have the question in your heart, have the concern, and make sure this concern is genuine, and make sure this concern is sincere, and Allah will open the answers in the Qur'an. This Qur'an has the answer for everything. And I remember this poem that one of the shu'a, one of the poets, his name is, I forgot his first name, but his last name is Al-Andalusi. He said, ستفقد إن جهلت وأنت باقٍ وتوجد إن علمت ولو فقدت. He said that you will be missing if you are ignorant, even though you are still alive and existent among the people. You exist, but you will be missing. وتوجد إن علمت. And you will exist if you knew and if you understood and if you had knowledge. And you will exist if you had knowledge, even if you were missing, even if you die and you are gone, because of your knowledge. Ya Ikhwan, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to aid us and assist us in raising our own children. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our offspring and to make us the best fathers for the best children. Ameen. Wa subhanaka Allahu wa hamdika astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Allah. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد. إخواني, after the first khutbah, it is only normal for each and every one of us to think, what will I leave behind? What am I for my children? And what legacy will I leave behind me? And how will my descendants be? This should be a genuine concern for every Muslim. Ikhwani, we are in the summer season. And it is from the nature of my khutab and durus in general to give something hands-on for the brothers and sisters to do after they leave the khutbah. And it is the last, it is the thing that I despise most, for someone to leave a khutbah that I just gave and say, what was that about? No, I want everyone to leave with one responsibility today. I want them to have one thing in mind. And that is, this is the summer season. My kids are off in school. They don't have school. We have free time. The weather is good. I have time. I can take some time off my job. What can I teach my kids? Or what can I involve my kids in so that I can be like Ibrahim alayhi salam and leave a legacy behind? Ikhwani, children remember every single thing you do with them. They will never forget. Sometimes it's a small look that you give them. Sometimes it's a frown. Sometimes it's a smile. Sometimes it's a compliment. Sometimes it's something bad. Sometimes a curse word may slip out. But they'll remember it their whole life. And you know that you can carve anything you want in the minds of these kids and in their own memories. What you have to do this summer, Ya Ikhwan, and start right now, as soon as you leave this khutbah, is to think, what will I do with my kids? I remember my kids, I live in Saudi Arabia, I don't live here. Over there, there are a lot of poor people in the streets. And in Saudi, even though it's a rich country, but there are, believe it or not, there are plenty poor people. And I thought of ibadah to do with my kids, something that they'll remember with me, something that I can involve them with. And I remember picking them up and taking them to the supermarket, a big hypermarket. And I told them, okay, we're going to buy things for poor people today. They said, Daddy, what are we going to do? I said, look, what we're going to do is we have to buy bags that look like this, that are about this size. And then we have to buy some cake, some chips, some juice, some pastries, something, nuts, anything that we can put and fit in this bag. And then take all that stuff home, and then pack it in bags, and then tie the bags, and perhaps even write a little note that I wish you eat this and make dua for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this from us, or something nice or kind to tell the poor person. And I did this with my kids. And they enjoyed the shopping. And they enjoyed the ride to the supermarket. And the ride back from the supermarket. And the hype right before we filled the bags. And then they enjoyed filling the bags with me. And they did it with me. And they even started saying, no, these are my bags. No, those are your bags. And these are mine. And see, they were fighting over the bags. And then we went out in the car and we went out to this poor area and we gave the bags out to the poor people. Who gave it? Not me, but my kids. And they saw the smiles on the faces of the poor people. And they were so happy. And they felt this rewarding feeling. Mind you, my kids are only 3 and 5. But they felt this feeling of good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards the act of good in this dunya before the akhirah. He rewards it with a blessed feeling, a good feeling in the heart of the believer. And not only a Muslim can, even a kafir can feel this good feeling. But the reward in the hereafter is for those who want it and those who believe in it. So this good feeling they feel, even though they don't know much. They don't know the reward of sadaqah. They don't know the reward of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared them times 10 and times 700 and all the ahadith that we know. No, they don't need to know that. But you know what they know? They know what they did is good. And they bug me all year around for that season, because we only do it the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Because actions are multiplied during those 10 days. So my kids bug me, Baba, is it time yet? Is it time to give sadaqah? We want to go out, Baba. Can we go shopping? And this is a beautiful feeling, Ikhwan. This is something that if I were to die today, they will remember me for. And this is something that I'm proud of. And this is something that I connected my kids with. And I want every single one of you to leave this masjid today and think of that one thing you will do with your kids. Whether it's Qiyam al-Layl, whether it's Zakawat, whether it's Sadaqat, whether it's smiling, whether it's imatatul adha an al-tariq, or shoveling your neighbor's driveway when it snows, or cleaning the masjid, vacuuming the masjid on a Thursday night before Jum'ah. It can be anything, ya ikhwan, but it's something your kids will remember you for. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our offspring. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the righteous believers who leave a good legacy behind, who leave something that they will be remembered for in this life and in the next. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaghfir lana warhamna. Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna. Wa'afina wa'afu anna. Watajawaz an siyyatina. Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna. اللهم اغفر لنا ولأزواجنا وذرياتنا ولمن له حق علينا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا اللهم اجمعنا في جناتك جنات النعيم اللهم اجمعنا في جناتك جنات النعيم في الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا أن آخر دعوانا Ya Rabbil Alameen, on this blessed day, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Today, Ikhwan, for those who don't know, was the first time the Yahud stopped the Muslimin from praying Jum'ah in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them and get them away from us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us victorious against these Yahud. They're preventing us from prayer. They're preventing us from Jum'ah. They're killing our men and women and children, Ya Ikhwan. The least we can do is make one sincere dua in our sujood today for Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may accept from us as those who did something for this cause. Barakallahu feekum, subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Jazakumullahu khairan wa atubu ilayk.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah.